Welcome everyone. So today we'll be discussing another topic from module 4 in traffic engineering and management. In the previous class we discussed what are traffic signals and the various advantages and disadvantages of traffic control signals. So we know that traffic lights or traffic signals are signaling devices that are positioned especially at road intersections and pedestrian crossings in order to allow the vehicles to stop and proceed. And they are actually control devices which alternately directs the traffic at intersections using various lights like the red light and the green light signals. And the main requirements of the traffic signal is to draw attention, provide meaning and time to respond and to have minimum waste of time. So today we are going to discuss the different types of traffic signal. So traffic signals may be broadly classified into three types. They are traffic control signals, then pedestrian signals and special traffic signals. So traffic control signals are further classified as fixed time signal, manually operated signal and automatic signal. So we'll discuss each of these. So firstly, the traffic control signals. So traffic control signals, they have actually three colored lights that will glow facing the direction of the traffic flow. And the three colors are red light, amber light and the green light. And here the red light is actually meant for it indicates the stop. That is, the vehicles will have to stop when the red light glows. And then when it comes to the green light, so green actually indicates to go. That is, the vehicles can move forward. And the light amber, that is amber or yellow light, it allows the clearance time for the vehicles that enters the intersection area at the end of the green time. So that is actually used to indicate the clearance time. So the amber light or the yellow light, it is used to clear the road when the signal is changing from the green light to the red light. So if by mistake a vehicle is caught in the amber signal in the middle of a large crossing road, it is advised that they have to continue with care and should not accelerate in panic. So these are the importance of the three colored lights. And a typical traffic signal head is as shown here in this figure. You can see red, amber or yellow and the green lights. Okay, so that's what these three colors actually indicates. And also there may be additional signals that shows the green lights for separate movements of traffic movements, and they may also be provided if at all it is necessary. Now coming to the different types of traffic control signals. So like I told you, there are three types, that is fixed time signal. Then we have the second one, that is manually operated signal, and then we have the automatic signal. So we'll see each of these. Firstly, coming to the fixed time signal. So the fixed time automatic traffic signal, this is a type which keeps repeating the same set of signal, and that is over a cycle of time. It will be already preset. So that is how here the change in color will keep repeating as the time is set. And this type of traffic signals, they actually function satisfactorily at locations where there is no significant variation in the flow of traffic on the roads. And also the timing of the phase of the cycle will be predetermined based on various traffic studies, and they are simplest and also the cheapest type of automatic traffic signal which are actually operated electrically. And the main drawback of this type of signal, that is a fixed time signal, is that when the traffic flow on one road may be almost nil and the traffic on the, say, the crossroad is very heavy, then yet what happens is the traffic in the heavy stream will have to keep waiting at the red phase, since already the time is preset. So the traffic will have to wait at whenever the light glows red. So, and there are also fixed time traffic signals in which the different sets of signal phases packages are meant for different timings of a day, and that also can be installed. So here the main features are that it uses a preset time interval, and mainly they are also used in areas, urban areas, and Another advantage is that it incurs very less initial cost, and also the ongoing maintenance cost is also comparatively lesser, and it also makes the pedestrians an equal part of the traffic signal system. So that is one advantage of the fixed time signals. Okay, so moving on to the next type, that is the manually operated signal. So when it comes to the manually operated signals, here there may be a traffic police who will watch the traffic demand from a suitable point, especially during the peak hours at the point of intersection of the roads, and the timings will vary based on these phases and cycle accordingly. And manually operated signals, they are operated from a salient point very near to the intersection of the roads, and the single phases may be carried or it may be varied depending upon the traffic demand at a particular point of time. So that is what is called as a manually operated signal. Now coming to the third type, that is the traffic actuated automatic signal. So what are they? So traffic actuated automatic signals are those where the timings of the phase and the cycle are changed based on the demand of the traffic, that is based on the traffic demand. So there are semi-actuated traffic signals, and in this case the normal green phase of an approach may be extended, say, to a certain period of time, and this is mainly to allow a few more vehicles to approach, which are almost approaching closely to clear off the intersection. So they need not wait. So that is one semi-actuated type of a traffic signal. And there are the fully actuated traffic signals. Here in this case, the detectors and computer will be there, which will assign the right way for the various traffic movements on the basis of the demand and also predetermined programming. One disadvantage is that this type of a system or a signal is very costly. So it is very costly if it has to be installed at all intersections. So that is what is the major disadvantage of this type of a signal. Now coming to the next type, that is the pedestrian signals. So pedestrian signals, it is given here, it is actually used to give the right way to the pedestrians to cross the road. So we know that when we say road users, it includes the drivers as well as the pedestrians. So pedestrian signals, these are actually installed at the intersections, which are controlled by the traffic signals, and it is installed to enable the pedestrians who use the road to safely cross the specified roads. And the signal for pedestrians to walk is usually a white walking symbol. So this is how usually the signal is represented. So whenever there is a white walking symbol, it indicates that the pedestrians can cross the road. And at certain locations of the mid-block stretches, especially in urban roads with very high demand for pedestrian crossing, there may be separate pedestrian signals that will be installed. And this is what a pedestrian signal will look like. And also a flashing or a steady orange hand symbol also sometimes, that actually means the pedestrians must not begin to cross. So these are the various types of pedestrian signals that are used in the to control the traffic flow. Now coming to the next type, that is the special traffic signals. So special traffic signals are those signals which are used to warn the traffic. So the special traffic signals, they are called so because of consists of flashing beacons, and they are installed at certain locations mainly to warn the traffic of, say, a particular situation. And at flashing red light signals, the drivers of the vehicles have to stop before entering the nearest crosswalk, say at an intersection, or there may be a stop line also that is provided on the road. So they will have to stop there whenever the light flashes red. And here again, the flashing yellow signals are actually used to caution. They are actually cautionary signals that that actually signifies that the drivers can proceed or drive or cross the road, but with caution. So that is what a yellow flashing signal indicates, and a red flashing signal indicates that they have to stop before they enter the crosswalk or at the stop signal. So these are the different types of signals. Thank you.